Hey everyone, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to add a featured image just like these that you see right here to your blog post. So if you're wondering how you can get these featured images on your blog post, then I'm going to show you exactly how to do that today. So guys, if you are creating the right images for your blog post and you want to create featured images, then you should be using, of course, a design tool, and you should already have those images on your computer. So one of the free tools that I use on my site is called Canva, and Canva is a free design tool that pretty much anybody could sign up for. It's very user-friendly, easy to use, very popular, and so Canva is where I create pretty much every image that I have, from my YouTube videos to my blog posts, any image that I'm using to do any type of promotion, I'm using Canva for it. So if you want to check out Canva and start using some images, then I will leave a link down in the description for you to get access to that for free. So let's head back over to WordPress. All right, now the first thing that you want to do is go to the post that you want to add your image to. So I'm going to go over here to the left where it says post, click on it. And then you should find the blog post that you want to add your featured image to. So I've been working on a couple, and I'm going to use this one just for demonstration purposes. I have not published it yet, so you will see the private mode on. But now as you scroll down to the right side over here, you will see, as you scroll just a little bit right under tags, you will see where it says featured image, and this is where you can set your featured image. Now, before you set your featured image, like I said, you need to have your image already downloaded. So you can click on featured image, and when you click on it, this is what opens up. So this is the media that I have already installed in here. I use this all the time, but what you want to do is upload your image. So I'm going to go over here to the left where it says upload files, and you can just either upload it by clicking files. I'm going to do the drag and drop. So I already have my image right here. I am going to move this over, drop it, and this is how it turns out. Now over here to the right, you'll see some information that's it's giving you, and also it is going to show you your alt tags. So your alt tags are just, you know, words that people would typically search for. And so what I like to put here are keywords that I use to search for, and keywords that I've already researched for. So I'm going to put generate insurance leads, and I'll just put it online, because if someone goes to Google and they're researching this or searching it in the Google search, then what would happen is under the image section, if someone found this image that I uploaded, these keywords of course would be attached, and people could click on the image and it would bring them back to my blog post. So that's a good way to drive traffic to your website, is by optimizing every single image that you have. So these are the keywords that I researched, and so I'm going to use this keyword in the alt tag section, and down in the description I'm just going to give a little description of what the image is about, and it's pretty much what the blog post is about. So I'm going to copy that there, and it says, instead of buying leads, learn how to generate life insurance leads online. So that's just a little description of this image. So from here, I am going to set featured image. Now you will see that this image pops up down here in the right hand corner. Now if you're concerned about this image fitting correctly, or maybe the image that you uploaded is not centered, or maybe the words are off of the page, or maybe it's too big or too small, I'm going to show you the dimensions that you need to have. So let's head back over to Canva. So inside of Canva, I'm going to show you where I actually upload a lot of these images, and so they're right here. One of the things that you need to have correctly is the dimension. And so the dimension that works best for me is 1000 by 667. So I'm going to show you how you can look at that. So if I hit the resize button, it will say that the width is 1000, the height is 667, and this is in pixels. So you should be using pixels for your dimensions for your featured image. And honestly, I use this image or these dimensions for my other images on my website. So 1,000 by 667 will give you this nice image right here, and it will not be too big, it will not be too small or anything like that. So you can use these images for your featured image on your blog post. So now that we have the featured image, let's go check out what the featured images look like on your blog. So once I head back over here, this is what I see. This is how a featured image would actually look. So if someone was on the homepage to your blog, this is what your featured image could look like. It will look exactly like this. So now let me click and go inside to show you how that looks. Okay, so now let me show you exactly how this is going to look since we're back in WordPress. I want to make sure that I update this because if you don't update it, you won't see the image. So now I'm going to go over here and I'm going to open up in a different window. All right, so this is it. This is how your featured image should look. It can show up at the top of your blog post as well. So you can have your featured image at the top of your blog post and also on the home page of your blog post. So that's it, everyone. That is how you add a featured image to your blog post. If you have any questions, leave me a comment down in the comment section below. And also give me a thumbs up if you like this video. Let me know what you think. All right, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.